kids, and then I brought Des Burris
My oldest will be coming here in a few years, so.
That'd be perfect timing. New gym in the back. This
real
is
good.
Gonna get changed next year.
Real good.
It'll be beautiful.
A lot of changes going on, yeah.
It'll be beautiful.
We moved out here about 12 years ago, and it's changed quite a bit.
Yeah.
It's quite a bit.
It's gonna change a lot more.
Yeah, good. Good.
All for the better.
Good stuff.
By the time he gets here, maybe even turf. Maybe.
Maybe, okay. Okay.
Is there anything else I can try?
What do they got going on this year as far as the build-up for you guys?
We built a new auxiliary gym in the back. This gives us 2 basketball courts, 3 volleyball courts, and 11 badminton courts.
11?
11 badminton courts. New classrooms in the front, new main office, new nurse's office.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, so it's really nice. Really, really
nice. You guys just moved into this one, didn't you?
Yes. Well, this one for a couple years, I think. Yeah. Yeah, that used to be the main office. Yeah, way back when. So, and then next year we're tearing this out, turning it this way. It'll be 3 courts and then stadium seating.
Nice.
So it'll go from 2,100 capacity to about 3,200 capacity.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Now, will that help with, like, getting regional and sectionals?
Well, we can get regionals, we can get girls sectionals, but we can't get boys sectionals. So, yeah, it'll help a lot with that. Plus, it'll give us space to do wrestling and so things in here.
Yeah,
it'll be nice. And the big thing, actually, is that it gives you an assembly space for the school. Because we don't have anywhere to put the kids right now for our school assembly.
Really?
Yeah.
What's enrollment at here?
2,600. That's huge. It's getting bigger. They say 3,200 within 5 years.
3,200, wow.
Yeah.
And he's going through the same issue.
He's already 2,200.
So they're going to go through, you think, and build the new school?
They're actually doing almost the same thing as us. They're doing classrooms, they're doing the auxiliary gym.
Okay.
They're not flipping the new,
yeah.
And they don't have the field, but they have the pool.
Sure.
So,
wow. That's nuts.
It's a big community. There's like, of the 24 schools in Oswego, there's actually just under 18,000 kids.
18,000?
Yeah.
Has it been that way for like several years, or is it still kind of growing?
Yeah, it's still growing. Yeah.
Well, you're starting to see the buildings take up
right
again now. So.
Yeah, I think we're the 9th biggest district in the state now.
Never would have known
Never thought that.
Right.
Holy cow.
Pretty impressive.
Do you live around here? Or?
I don't. I live in Bloomingdale.
Okay.
So it's, you know, 355, 88 around here.
Yeah.
But I was at IC and Elmhurst for 12 years before that, and then Benton in Bensonville for 8 years before that.
Okay.
So, I'm happy to be here. It's a good move. Very good move. And I get the broadcast game.
I was saying, you do an iHi, is that what it is?
No, this is IHSA TV.
Oh.
So it's in its infancy. I did it at IC for a couple of years, so I know what I'm doing. But the plan is, obviously, to teach the kids how to do it. Yeah.
Nice.
So hopefully by next year, the kids will be broadcasting all home games.
Now, do they have like a big production?
Yeah, they do.
Okay.
Yeah, we have Panther TV.
Nice.
Incorporating them with it. But we brought it in kind of middle of the year, so it's hard to incorporate it right away.
Is that just showing just locally then, or is it?
It's webcast.
Oh, it's webcast.
Anywhere. Yeah.
Do they do advertising on it then?
We can.
Nice.
Yeah. That's the plan for the future.
Absolutely.
That's the difference between this and like
iHi
or
this time we do have a special presentation. This evening we'd like to recognize a lady who epitomized the spirit of a Panther. Kathy Schnabel, wife of our former girls basketball coach and current assistant boys basketball coach Mike Schnabel, and the mother of our current Panther basketball coach Kevin Schnabel, died on June 8th of 2012, but will always be a part of the lives she touched. Kathy spent a great deal of time in our gym, whether watching her sons Kevin and Mark and daughter Kelly play basketball, or watching Mike and later Kevin coach basketball. Wife, mother, daughter, sister, grandmother, aunt, and friend, Kathy was a special person beloved by many. Her loss has left a huge hole in a number of hearts. Yet Kathy's spirit lives on, and tonight we celebrate the American Heart Association by remembering Kathy, who once said this about basketball and the Oswego Panther community in a Chicago Tribune article discussing the impact of both on her family. It has been fun. We've met a lot of nice families and a lot of nice kids. In recognition of Kathy, tonight Oswego High School dedicates this sign in her honor, which is given by Mr. Mike Wayne to our basketball captains. Kathy was truly a Panther. Presenting the sign to Kathy's family are our four basketball captains, Miles, Jack, Jamal, and Trevor. At this time, we ask that you all please rise. Gentlemen, remove your hats. You're in for a special treat. The singing of our national anthem by Oswego High School senior Natalie Thompson. Now the starting lineup for Plainfield South. Number one, Mike Ballantyne. Number three, Corey Ebers. Number 22, James Hill. Number 33, Miles Snowden. And number 44, Sean Goff. The Cougars assistant coach is Phil Bukowski, and the head coach is Tim Bowe. And now the starting lineup for your Oswego Panthers. Number 10, a 6'3 senior, Jamal Richardson. Number 15, a 6'1 senior, Miles Simulton. Number 20, a 6'3 senior, Elliot McCoy. Number 33, a 6'3 senior, Darian Reddick. And number 40, a 6'4 senior, Chet Kwiatkowski. Oswego's assistant coaches, Jim Bagley and Matt Bowerman. Also, the director of Panther basketball operations, Mr. Mike Schnabel, the head coach, Kevin Schnabel.
And we welcome you to Panther basketball. Special night, American Heart Association Red Out, honoring Kathy Schnabel, the mother of head coach Kevin Schnabel, and assistant coach, the wife of Mike Schnabel. Mike is also being inducted into the Hall of Fame this year, the Illinois Basketball Coaches Association Hall of Fame. Tonight it's the Plainfield South Cougars at 4-12. Against the Oswego Panthers, coming in at 18-2. Simulton and Snowden with the jump. Pass to Kwiatkowski. And the Panthers are on the board first.
Assisted by Jamal Richardson. Alternate possession goes to Plainfield South. Traveling violation. McCoy. Two-point basket, James Hill. Line shooting two will be Miles Snowden. Fouls on Miles Simon. Snowden back to the line shooting two. Jamal Richardson on the foul. Delvin Harris into the lineup for the Cougars. On Miles Snowden, Darian Reddick at the line shooting two. Three-point basket, James Hill. Fouls on Miles Snowden, that's his second. Miles Simulton at the line shooting a pair. Garrett into the lineup for the Cougars. foul on Darian Reddick. That's his first. Oswego's third. Passed it by James Hill, assisted by Alonzo Garrett. Substitutions for Oswego. Zach West and Danny Mangers. Sean Goff in for the Cougars. Josh Oros also in the game for Oswego. Corey Evers at the line shooting two. Fouls on Miles Simulton, that's his second. McCoy, assisted by Zach West. Miles Simulton, assisted by Danny Manger. Corey Evers. In for Plainfield South, Galen Edwards, number 14. Simulton. Galen Edwards, three-point basket. And at the end of one, Plainfield South 18, Oswego 17. Each year, about 700,000 Americans have a new or repeat stroke. Over 150,000 of them die making stroke the fourth leading cause of death. The American Heart Association and the American Stroke Association needs your help. Every 29 seconds, an American will suffer a coronary event. Every dollar helps save lives. The money donated tonight for the red shirts all goes to the American Heart Association. At halftime, if you have a ticket, be sure and get it out late in the second quarter. We have a Converse gift card up for an award for anyone who can make a layup, a free throw, a three-point basket, and a half-court shot in 30 seconds. Have those raffle tickets handy at the end of the second quarter. Shooting foul on Miles Simonton, that's his third. Sean Goff at the line shooting two. Zach West returns for the Panthers. Hill back into the game for the Cougars. Jack Kwiatkowski assisted by Jamal Richardson. Thank you. is, first, Darian Reddick will be shooting three shots. Foul on Alonzo Garrett, that's his first. Foul on Sean Goff, that's his first. Jack Kwiatkowski makes the first of two. Delvin Harris returning for the Cougars. Timeout, Plainfield South. It is a 30-second timeout. Get out your red tickets. Get out your red tickets. If I call your number, meet Mr. Johnson right here at the scores table. First red ticket, 674-789. Second red ticket, 674-828. Third, 674-871. And the last, 674-907. 789, 828, 871, and 907 are the last three numbers of the four winning tickets. If you have one, meet Mr. Johnson. Jack Kwiatkowski assisted by Elliot McGoy. Miles Snowden back in the game. Foul was on Delvin Harris. Kwiatkowski at the line trying to complete the three-point play. Danny Manders returns for the Panthers. And Josh Earls returns for the Panthers. Yeah. James Hill puts Oswego in the bonus. Jack Kwiatkowski back into the game for Oswego. Zach West at the line for the Panthers. James Hill. Josh Oros. Assisted by Elliot McGoy. Miles Snowden. Timeout, Plainfield South. We have two unclaimed red tickets. 674-789 and 674-907. Please see Mr. Johnson. It's your last chance. 674-789, 674-907. Once again, those last three numbers on those tickets, 907 and 789. See Mr. Johnson if you have one. If those tickets aren't claimed, we will redraw two more. Calvin Brooks, number 23 in the game for Plainfield South. We have two new tickets, 674-845, 674-894. 845-894. See Mr. Johnson. Jamal Richardson is second. Jack Kwiatkowski back into the game. Mr. Johnson is at the head table here. Winning tickets are 674-845, 674-894. And at the end of one, Oswego 40, Plainfield South 23. One more winning ticket, 674-894, 674-894. Rebound basket by Sean Goff. Is on Corey Evers. At the line, Elliot McGoy. McGoy from Czech Kuykowski. Simon for three. Elliot McGoy at the line shooting two. Ball is on 44, Sean Goff. That's his second. Was on Sean Goff as his third. Alonzo Garrett back into the lineup for Plainfield South.
Oh!
Darian Reddick. Jamal Richardson, that's his third. Alonzo Garrett at the line shooting a pair. Substitutions, 11, Delvin Harris, and 35, Andrew Smith, for Plainfield South. Danny Mangers and Josh Oros for Oswego. Sean Goff back in the game for the Cougars. Driving layup by Mike Valentine. Miles Simulton. 30-second timeout for Oswego. A reminder, next Friday night, the Panthers host Oswego East. You must purchase a ticket in advance. It will undoubtedly be a sellout. Tickets go on sale on Monday. Even if you have a pass, such as a Booster Club pass or a Senior Citizen pass, you must exchange those for a ticket for Friday night's game. Please don't wait. Possession goes to Plainfield South on the jump ball. Darian Reddick. Oh. blocking foul on Josh Oros. That's his first. Substitutions, Miles Snowden for Plainfield South. Jamal Richardson, Jack Wiedkowski, and Zach West for Oswego. Corey Evers back for the Cougars. Jack Kwiatkowski, assisted by Elliot Benoit. Offensive foul is the call on Alonzo Garrett. That's his second. Calvin Brooks into the game for the Cougars. Driving layup by Elliot McGoy, assisted by Danny Mangers. Basket is good by Sean Goff. On Danny Mangers, his second. Josh Orles and Darian Reddick returning for Oswego. Miles Simulton also back in the lineup for Oswego. Come on, we're off. Josh Jamerson. And Trevor Hammond. All in for the Panthers. Jalen Edwards and Mike Valentine in the game of Plainfield South. Charlie Janowski is first. Andrew Smith into the game for Plainfield South. Jalen Edwards for three, assisted by Andrew Smith. Thank you. also Sean Goff for the Cougars. Thank you.